Scott is from, I think, originally from Muhlenberg County, now lives in Lexington. And he's, I think, one of the editors of the Kentucky Thumb Pickers newsletter with Tut Razor. So we're going to introduce Scott. He's been in a lot of these contests. So I'm going to let him tell you what he's going to play, and it may be several then. Scott?
Thanks. Glad to be here. It's great to be able to do this year after year, so we really appreciate the opportunity. I'm going to do one Tom Bresch's tune because it's kind of like Travis, and I can play it. That's why. He picks thumb pick or rock or jazz or anything. So I'm going to play one of his. It was written by Julian Lennon called Saltwater.
called Bells of St. Mary.
every year she's put this on, and she's done all the work and everything. She's had some good help. We're not going to say anything about the help. She's had good help. But anyway, she has put this on every year, and she's getting ready to retire from this year. So she's got more grandkids and everything she has to entertain over Thanksgiving, so she's going to step out. Before she does, we want to recognize her for all the work she's done. Now, something we do here in the county, if someone does something to bring a lot of recognition to our county, we make them an outstanding citizen. So that's what we want to do for Dorothy tonight. We want to make her an outstanding citizen of Newburgh County for all of her work that she does to bring recognition to Newburgh County. And like I say, she's the one who is responsible this entire night and for all the years it's going on. So let's recognize Dorothy with an outstanding citizen of Newburgh County. Now, there's one other thing we want to do. She has a husband that was a judge for several years, and now she has a daughter that's a judge. And so she won't be left out, and she can have a little notoriety around the house. We're going to make her an honorary judge tonight. So she is now an honorary judge of Newburgh County. So this doesn't have a whole lot of clout to it. But on the other hand, you can hold your own around the breakfast table with your family. So we're going to make her an honorary judge of Newburgh County.
As you all know, I'm with the Kentucky Thumb Pickers Club, and we appreciate this type of activity down here. It's the kind of thing that keeps thumb picking going. So we wanted to present these certificate of appreciation, one for Dorothy Paxton and one for Judge Rodney Kirtley, for the continued support of thumb picking.
I will say just a few words. This wouldn't be here if that moral support standing there wasn't. He's done so much for thumb picking, and I'm so proud of him. And this probably won't be the end of the Travis tribute. So be watching your papers next year. I won't be in charge, but I'll sure be helping with whatever comes up. So it's the last time it will be on a Thanksgiving weekend, and those of you who have been so faithful for 9 years, you know, don't just automatically get in your car after you eat Thanksgiving dinner and come here, because it won't be here. But sometime during the year, something special will be happening. And it's been great to meet all the thumb pickers, and they are a super group, and I've enjoyed it all. But I do thank Rodney for all he's done. And if you haven't seen Merle Travis' home that's been moved to Paradise Park, be sure to do that. Thanks a lot.
All right. Another group. And I think they call themselves Over But Number 9. Benny Lear, Paul Mosley, and Paul's son Michael on the bass. Good hot group here, fine pickers. So we'll let them start.
If you're ready.
I guess we're going to do a song here by a fellow from Tupelo, Mississippi. Come out this song, 1956. Scotty Moore played thumbstock guitar on it. Mm-hmm. of view. That's all right, mama, yes, anything you do, that's all right. Well, that's all right. That's all right now, mama, anything you do. Well, papa, he done told me, mama done told me too. Son, that gal you fooling with, she ain't no good for you. Well, that's all right. Well, that's all right. That's all right now, mama, anything you do. Mr. Paul Mosley. Billy, I guess you'd call it, Ricky Nelson song. Mr. Al Harris from Louisiana was going to be here with us tonight, but he couldn't make it. He used to play with Ricky Nelson. He plays keyboard. He was here last year. So he told, for everybody, he said to say hello to everybody. So Al'll probably be back next year, we hope. This song here is called Mary Lou. James Bird played thumb style on it. Guitar up here on front row here, Mr. Dickie Shelton. Mr. Dickie's a fine guitar player. We just want to play one tonight. He might play one a little bit later. Play Billy Seegers, different ones. Moses, wherever you come up Moses' house all the time and play. But we're going to do, Working Man Blues.
Thank you.
He is from the, started in Nashville when the business was completely different than it is today, the old country music. Back in the 50s, started with the Louvin Brothers. You still hear him on some of those records that they play of the old Louvins. Then was Kitty Wells several years, and then Jerry Reed, and of course the last probably 25 years.
Can't keep a job.
He just can't keep a job, like he says. But he's been with Chet, his company's right-hand man, so it's an honor to introduce Mr. Paul Yandell.
Thanks.
Thanks, Dave. I'll give you that 50 cents when I get off here. Well, it's good to be up here again. I'm sorry this is going to be the last time, but maybe somebody will leap into the breach and keep it going. Dorothy's done a great job all these years. I've enjoyed coming up here, and I know y'all have too. I play about 5 minutes a week. Be honest with you, since Chet got sick, I don't have much incentive to play anymore. And so I don't practice. I'm into ham radio and this and that, so I do all that other stuff, and I just don't pick much. But I played enough, I think, and let the young guys do it. But anyway, I'm going to try to play you two or three here, and we'll see what happens. Thank you. give Mr. Paul Yandell another hand. Thank you. Let's give Mr. Rance Paxton, little fella been putting these names up here. Let's give him a hand. He's been working all part of the night. Rance Paxton, that's Dorothy's grandson. Well, I'm going to introduce Mr. Eddie Fenton. He's coming up here and do a few songs. Alonzo's going to play the rhythm for you. Let's give Mr. Eddie Fenton.
Big after Paul Yandell plays. Looked around, that's the biggest they could get. Well, it's nice to be over and see everybody tonight and all. Have some fun, is it? I've been out taking thumb picking. We've been out on the West Coast. I've been out to through Arizona and Washington State and Oregon and California the last month. And all in, they may never let thumb picker back in that country, but got to see some nice places and all. And glad I got to hang around some of these guitar players enough to get to go out and do something like that. On a Sunday morn. And of course it was against his religion, but still he took his gun along. Well, he shot himself some mighty fine quail and one little old measly hare. Now on his way returning home, he met a great big grizzly bear. Well, the bear marched out in the middle of the road as mean as he could be. And the preacher commenced to climb him right up a tree. Well, the bear sat down and he rolled his eyes and shook his ugly head. The preacher, he looked up to the sky and these are the words he said. He said, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the lion's den. You delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale. And then you freed the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace like the good book do declare. Lordy, lordy, if you can't help me, please don't help that bear. Mm-hmm. climbing that tree, and that made the preacher sore. So the preacher, he climbed still higher till he couldn't climb anymore. Well, about that time, the limbs gave away and they both come a-tumbling down. Now when that old preacher, he began to pray, you could hear him for miles around. He said, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the lion's den. You delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale then. You freed the Hebrew children from the fire furnace like the good book do declare. Lordy, Lordy, if you can't help me, please don't help that bear. Well, old Bear was really laying it on, but the preacher was doing all right. He dragged that beast right into the water, it was three times in and out. Now when that old bear got up and limped away, that preacher, he began to shout. He said, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the lion's den. You delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, well, amen. Well, it may not seem like much to you from where you sit up there, but the hardest job that I've ever done was a baptizing that bear. Thank you. Made me glad that I got back home there, and a lot of turkey and stuff like that. I'm going to mess a tune up here now, about like most of them I do, but Dickie Shelton sitting out here making me nervous. A great guitar player there, a lot of them haven't got to hear Dickie, but I heard him a long time ago at Moles Rager's house. Met him one night at Central City Studio over there. I got to go with Moles down there. Dickie was a great player back then, he's even better now, maybe he's going to pick after a while. And I tell you, it's so nice to get to come see one of my greatest heroes, Paul Yandel, play. We're fortunate to get somebody like that to come play for us and all. I told him he was my opening act tonight. One of the first thumb-picking tunes that ever got played out anywhere, I read that Merle Travis said he went over to Evansville and got to play on the radio and said he tried to play the Tiger Rag as much like Moles Rager as he could. Now, I never really got to hear Moles when he was back hot playing the Tiger Rag, and I can't play it hot anyhow, but here's my interpretation of a hot Tiger Rag. Thank you.
I hate to see that this is the last one, but I'm sure, you know, like you said, that somebody else will pick it up and we'll be down here again. But, you know, Dave and I are going to play a couple of three songs, and I've been saving the best to last. The reason I did this to last, see, I figured if you run me off, I won't have to be back anymore anyway, because I'm going to sing one tonight, so get ready. Somebody bolt the doors back, are we? But I'm going to do it later. David Duncan and myself. Me, Chuck Ray.
Thank you.
everybody got the doors bolted. I get nervous and I might get the words wrong, but anyway. While I'm up here, I'll just say, I come out with a CD. I got brave enough to do it one day. And we put some of these songs on the CD. And we got some of them down here to sell tonight. If anybody wants any, I might be able to sell you one. But anyway, if you get a little taste of it, see whether it's torture or not. So if you don't, if you think you can't use it, you could buy one and let you use it for a frisbee for your dog. You know, it'd be an expensive frisbee. This is what I call the Red Ragged Medley. Jealous when they see my playmate so sweet. Oh, fast when we come to the hilltop, we'll glide down the hill, you and me. Won't you ride in my little red wagon? You are my sweetheart to me. Dave's gonna pick it.
Thank you.
Legends, the thumb picking contest, and then that same day, the open contest, which is everything but thumb picking. And I recall the first time I went to Eddie's house, 1987, we went up to see John Travis. Alonzo was just a little bitty boy picking, so he's come a long way. And Mr. Alonzo Pennington and his bass player, Michael Moser.
I hope y'all are having a good time tonight, because I sure am.
Tunes that I like to do out of places. An old one, one of Moe's Records old favorites. It's called the Backwater Blues.
Well, it rained 5 days and the sky turned dark at night. It rained 5 days and the sky turned dark at night. To pack up my things and go. Well, there's thousands of people along that got no place to go. light and the winds begin to grow. It thundered and lightened, all the winds began to blow. Lord, there's thousands of people and they got no place to go.
Well, I have to turn around, Gary. All three of these houses were built by Mose Rector. He used to have a barbershop over on the far side of town and a little store. And he moved over to this side of town and built the white house that's right behind us here. Lived there for a while, built the middle house, and then finally built the one where his widow lives over here now. So that is the house where Laverta Rector lives right now, Mose's wife. And his daughters owned the other until recently, and one of them sold the white house. And the monument that you see of Mose Rector back here in this Home of the Legends fountain was dedicated in 1990 or maybe 1991. The city put up all of those for Mose and for his widow and for all the Pickers. The Fountain of the Legends is for all the Pickers: Merle Travis, Mose Rector, Ike Everly, and Kennedy Jones. It's four of them that we call the four legends here. That's about the history of it.
Okay, Bob, I appreciate it very much.